Hi, this is Lynn from wisconsingarden.com, and we took a look at our grapes today and we decided some of them need to be harvested. These are beautiful, so I'm going to take my clipper, clip it off. Now there is some little markings on some of them. I'm not going to worry about that because for the use I'm having them for, it doesn't matter what the skin looks like. So this is a fantastic harvest that we're going to have. We've been watching them all year. Last year we had very few.
Well, the year before that, you actually made this incredible
grape nectar
that was so smooth. I mean,
yes. Wow. And that's my plan for this year. So last year we got none. This year we'll have a lot.
Yeah, the other thing, too, is, you know, we planted, I think, what, four different varieties?
Mm-hmm.
But they're all starting to look the same.
They all pretty much look the same. I don't know what happened to our white Niagaras.
It looks like they cross-pollinated or something.
Everybody turned purple.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's something that usually happens or if maybe the Niagara ones didn't have any berries this year or grapes. I see a couple yellow ones sitting there, but maybe we didn't get to them fast enough and the birds ate them, but look at that. That's beautiful.
Yeah.
Absolutely beautiful.
Well, even up here there's some.
Mm-hmm.
But it could be that they just haven't matured yet.
Yes.
And some of them haven't matured at all.
Right.
But.
And some have, so.
And again, this was just a little experiment. I mean, we're not here to start a vineyard, but we thought it would be interesting to add, maybe about 4 to 6 grapevines to our Wisconsin garden, just to experiment with them and see what happens.
Right, and they've done very well. We'll have to do some trimming this year, but that's something you do when it's dormant anyway, so that's good.
The other thing, too, is we use this green aluminum wire.
It's coated with
vinyl. And it really sags, so it really didn't maintain the height structure that I was after.
No, but it did separate them. I mean, and it gives them structure, so as long as it stays at that height, or unless maybe after the leaves die off, we could tighten it up a little bit more.
Yeah, but I think that aluminum wire is just going to continue to stretch, and I think eventually if we really want it to be solid, we're probably going to have to go to a steel wire.
Maybe.
But all the things one learns when they're having fun growing grapes.
That's right.
I mean, there's a lot of them here. Makes me want to go to Italy.
Just stomping shoes
France.
On?
France. Yeah. I think of Lucy.
Well, this is what we got today. There are some that are still green, there's some that are ready, and there's some that are questionable, so I'll have to go through these. And Rick thinks there probably are about this many that still have to ripen.
Oh, easily, yep.
We have a couple weeks yet before frost, so that's good. As long as the birds don't get them all, we'll be happy.
Yeah. Well, I think also I'm going to take some cuttings and see if we can get some other ones started.
Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoy growing grapes, give us a thumbs up. If you have a recipe that you enjoy and would like to share, we'd love to hear from you. And as always, if you want to subscribe, we'd be very happy too for you to join our garden family.
Well, are you going to try making wine?
I don't think so.
Oh, okay.
Nectar, yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Very good.